Welcome to the Mold Busters Video Training Seminars. My name is Charlie, and today we're going to be looking at Health Canada regulations. Now, Health Canada has established a set of risk assessment and management guidelines for indoor air quality. They've called it the Residential Indoor Air Quality Guidelines. Original, I know. But these guidelines are actually based on the best scientific information available. Now, these guidelines summarize the health risks posed by specific indoor air pollutants, including mold, carbon monoxide, radon, ozone, formaldehyde, and nitrogen dioxide. These guidelines summarize the known health effects and indoor sources of each pollutant. They also provide a recommended exposure level below which health effects are unlikely to occur. It's important to remember the guidelines are recommendations only. Health Canada has stated that mold growth in residential buildings may pose a health hazard. Health risks depend on exposure and on allergic sensitization. People living in buildings with dampness or mold are more likely to suffer from symptoms like eye, nose, and throat irritation, coughing, wheezing, shortness of breath, and other allergic reactions. Especially people with asthma, their asthmatic symptoms are likely to increase in the presence of mold. The penetration of mold spores and mycelial fragments into the bronchial tree depends on their size. Smaller particles penetrate deeper into the lungs. However, exposure limits for mold have not been established because of two things. One, the large number of mold species growing in buildings, and two, the wide range of human responses to mold exposure. As such, Health Canada advises a few things in order to prevent mold growth from occurring. One is to control humidity. Two is to repair any water damage that may have occurred. And three, it's to thoroughly clean any visible or concealed mold growing in residential buildings. These recommendations apply regardless of the mold species found to be growing in the building. In general, mold awareness has been increasing in the media. From celebrities to TV shows and movies, the public is starting to see an increasing number of environment and mold-related legal battles in the media. For a good example of that, check out Aaron Brockovich. Now, the advent of the internet has given people the ability to quickly obtain information about anything and everything. The internet has allowed for the dissemination of information about mold and its dangers. People can now take immediate action and protect themselves and their families against mold. It's important, though, to make sure that your sources online are from verified mold professionals. The last thing you want to be doing is taking unverified information and applying it into your family's home. For a great resource, visit our website at www.busmold.com. Be sure to look for our mold library for the greatest resources available on this subject. Thank you very much.